fundus examination, papilledema and papillitis by our joint secretary, the neurosurgeon in Surya Hospital, Dr. K. Subramanian.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I am going to take you through some basic points that you already know. So kindly consider this as an academic brush-up. What is the fundus of the eye? This is the interior surface of the eye opposite the lens. This includes the retina, the optic disc, macula, fovea, and the posterior fold. Fundus, as we see it, is the window to the brain. Increased intracranial pressure is reflected on the optic disc and surrounding structures with no barriers at all. You look through the air, through clear tissue and clear fluid. Fundus examination can answer most symptoms caused by eye disease. What do we use? This is an ophthalmoscope. It was invented by Charles Babbage in 1847. Independently by Hermann von Helmholtz in 1851. Only after 1851 did it gain importance. The technique is the patient is sitting, looking straight. Shortly I will show you a video. The examiner standing approaches laterally, looks for the red reflex, proceeds in the same direction, and then traces the vessels to the optic disc. Look at this video. Ask the patient look over the left shoulder, darken the room, use the left eye and the left arm to look at the patient's left eye, and similarly your right eye and right arm to look at the patient's right eye. Start at around 15 inches away from the eye, go closer, laterally from about 15 degrees. Look for the red reflex and then go in. This is the optic disc, central orange area. You look at the vessels. The moving light is the focus. Note the color of the disc. Look at the margins. Normally the disc is about yellowish and the margin to the cup ratio is 2:1. The important areas are to look at the edges. The difference in diopter focus as you come into the cup and the vessels as they cross each other, as well as the vessels themselves. The veins will pulsate inside the eye. The artery's pulsation is not that clearly visible. Veins may be engorged. There may be retinal hemorrhages or exudates. Look all over the area that is visible to you. Normally there should be no exudates, no hemorrhages. And finally, have a look at the macula. If the patient looks directly into the light source, you will be looking at the macula. If you want to look at anterior structures, focus in the +12 or +10 and you can look at the lens. Now this is a must during any eye exam or nervous system exam and must be performed routinely. It just takes 2 minutes. When you start, you will take 5 minutes. Then it's only a matter of few seconds. Practice makes perfect. You must check both the sides always. You must compare with the other eye and match it to your memory database. What is the mechanism of papilledema? Developmentally and histologically, optic nerve is part of the brain and is surrounded by 3 meninges, the dura, arachnoid and the pia. The dura becomes continuous with the orbital periosteum and the arachnoid and pia fuse with the sclera. So subarachnoid space around the optic nerve is continuous to the brain subarachnoid space. Therefore, the rise in intracranial pressure is transmitted into the optic nerve. Rise in ICP results in compression of the central retinal vein as it crosses the subarachnoid space. It impedes lymphatic drainage from the retina, interferes with the slow component of anterograde exoplasmic transport within the nerve base. Thus, the swelling of the axons in the optic disc and surrounding retina occurs. Progressive changes we see in papilledema are congestion of retinal vessels with loss of venous pulsation, hyperemia of disc and filling of the physiologic cup. The disc edges will be blurred. I will show you through a series of images a little later. First the upper, then lower margins, then nasal margins, finally temporal margins. Elevation of the nerve head, what was initially a cup, will become convex. And this will be a difference in focus. As you keep focusing, you will know how much the edema is. The spread of the edema to the retina is called as the macular fan. There may be a hump of vessels leaving the disc. The vessels may appear and disappear as they course near the disc in progressive papilledema. Subsequently, the disc swelling reduces. The disc becomes yellowish white like a moon, and the veins remain congested. The edges of the disc may become indistinct. These are the pictures. To your left side is a normal disc. To the right side, as you see, there is an indistinct margin here. That is the nasal side. This is grade 2 papilledema. The edema is all round. This is grade 3. The vessels are humped as they leave the disc area. This is grade 4. The disc margin is no longer seen. This is grade 5. Not even the vessels are seen near the area of this. In a resolving papilledema, the venous congestion disappears. Pulsation returns. But the other changes take a long, long time to come back. There can be absence of papilledema in increased ICP. The optic subarachnoid space may be congenitally absent, may be occupied by inflammation or obstructed by neoplasm, or the optic nerve fibers may be already atrophied. Increased ICP causes craniocerebral volume disproportional to the bone, obstruction to space of circulation and absorption, and edema surrounding a pathological lesion, obstruction to venous drainage. It can also be classified as congenital, traumatic, inflammatory, neoplastic, vascular or benign ICP. Of course, the number of variables will increase. Papillitis, on the other hand, is an inflammation or infarction of the optic nerve head and usually caused by optic neuritis and multiple sclerosis. Ophthalmologists in the room can correct me if I am wrong. These are the differentiating features between optic neuritis and papilledema. That is why I say always compare with the other side and always compare with your memory database. Generally in a medical camp, if you see the neurologist will be looking only into one eye to save time, but that is wrong. In optic neuritis, it is a strictly unilateral disease. Papilledema is almost always bilateral. In optic neuritis, there is pain on eye movement, in papilledema none. Also, the visual loss is sudden and gross, pardon me for the typo, in optic neuritis. It is gradual in papilledema and slight except in post-papilledemic optic atrophy. Color vision is impaired in optic neuritis, especially to red and green. Field defect in optic neuritis is central or a centrosecal scotoma, whereas in papilledema it is an enlarged blind spot and peripheral constriction. Pupillary reaction is ill-sustained in optic neuritis. Degree of disc swelling is less than 3 diopters. Venous engorgement is less marked. And venous pulsation is present in neuritis, absent in papilledema. Hemorrhages are uncommon in neuritis, may be present in later stages of papilledema. And slit lamp examination for cells in vitreal is positive in optic neuritis and negative in papilledema. Differential diagnosis of a papilledema in include acute intraocular pressure, optic neuritis, edema associated with disease of retinal arteries, malignant hypertension, genital arthritis. Massive increases in CSF protein are seen in Guillain-Barré syndrome and spinal neurofibroma. Changes in composition of the blood, anemia, acute iron deficiency and sickle cell, and in polycythemia vera. Continuing with differential diagnosis, venous obstruction due to other causes, thrombosis of single vein of retina, mass lesions of the orbit, hemangioma, meningioma, neurofibroma are very common. Cavernous sinus thrombosis also very common. Keratodocavernous fistula can happen post-traumatic. Superior sagittal and lateral sinus thrombosis. Intrathoracic venous obstruction as seen in mediastinal tumors, aortic aneurysm and severe emphysema. Miscellaneous causes can include eclampsia, premenstrual edema, vitamin E excess or deficiency, tetracycline administration, leukemia and lead poisoning. This is a picture of optic atrophy. The central disc, there is no longer a cup. The vessels may or may not be nipped as they go in. The disc itself appears to be like the new full moon. It's caused by chronic edema, infection or tumor, sometimes injury. Increased ICP will not be reflected on an atrophic disc and will need other modalities of diagnosis. Thank you.